Hi friends, what do you think is more dangerous? A coconut falling from a tree or a bullet fired from a gun? Let's find out in this video. I'm sure you're thinking a bullet is more dangerous, right? We think a bullet is more dangerous since it travels really fast. Now, speed of the bullet depends on the type of gun used. Let's take the average speed of the bullet as 400 meters per second. Now that's really fast because it means it's traveling 400 meters every second. Now what is the speed of the coconut when it falls from a coconut tree? In case you guys missed my video on how dangerous is a falling coconut, do check it out. As we saw in the video, the height of the coconut tree was about 15 meters. If the coconut falls from the top of the tree, how do we calculate the speed when it hits the ground? We can use the equations of motion to find out. Because when the coconut starts to fall, what will be its initial velocity? That's right, zero, since the motion has just started. And the distance or displacement traveled by the coconut is 15 meters, the height of the tree. The coconut is falling faster and faster. It's accelerating due to gravity. So we need to use the acceleration due to gravity g, which is approximately 10 meters per second square. Now with this data, we can use the third equation of motion, v square equal to u square plus 2as, to calculate the final velocity when the coconut hits the ground. So if you substitute the values and do the calculations, you'll get that the final velocity v is square root of 300, which is 17.32 meters per second, or approximately 17 meters per second. Of course, we are ignoring the air friction here. So if we compare the speed of the bullet and the speed of the falling coconut, clearly the bullet is much faster. But don't you think we also need to consider how heavy the moving object is? So we also need to consider the mass of the object. And that's why it's better to use the concept of momentum in physics and not just velocity. What is momentum? Momentum is the product of mass and velocity. So it considers both these quantities. And it can help us to determine how dangerous the moving object is going to be. Now, what is the mass of the bullet? It depends on the type of bullet. Let's take the average mass of the bullet as 10 grams. So the momentum of the bullet will be mass times velocity, which is 10 grams multiplied by 400 meters per second. 10 grams is 10 by 1000 kg. Remember, we need to convert to SI units, so which is 1 by 100 kg. And when we multiply it with the velocity, the momentum of the bullet is 4 kg meter per second. Now let's look at our coconut. The mass of the coconut is about 1 kg. And if you multiply it with the velocity with which the coconut hits the ground, the momentum is about 17 kg meter per second. So as you can see, the coconut's momentum is about 4 times the momentum of the moving bullet. So the coconut will be more dangerous if it hits the person. Because when it hits the person, it will transfer this large momentum to the person. The force will be high and it can really hurt or even kill the person. The bullet has a much lower momentum. But since it's pointed and sharp, it can go into the person's body and can cause internal damage, which can also be deadly. So as you learned that based on physics, a falling coconut is actually more dangerous than a fast-moving bullet because it has large mass and hence its momentum is much higher than a moving bullet. Now if we consider a car which is moving very slowly at a speed of only 1 meter per second and it collides against a wall or a person, do you think it's dangerous? Let's say the mass of the car is about 1000 kg. So see if you can apply the concept of momentum and decide if this slow moving car is also dangerous. The mass of the car is 1000 kg and its speed is 1 meter per second. And do let me know what do you think by putting it in the comments below. And if you like this video, do hit the like button and share it out with your friends. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel, what are you waiting for? Please hit the subscribe button right now and click on the notification bell so that you don't miss any of our interesting science and maths videos and study tips videos. And do check out the full courses on our website manochaacademy.com and our Android app Manocha Academy. We have courses on physics, chemistry, biology, maths and computer coding. In these courses, you're going to get live classes, interactive videos, quizzes, questions, mock tests and revision notes. So do check out our courses. I'll put the links below and please do share it with your friends. And do stay connected with Manocha Academy and keep learning.